Hello everyone, welcome to Novation. I am Shantanu and I bring to you the second part of our current affairs question for the month of October 2019. And friends, we are going to do some of the very good questions which will be a very good learning experience to you. So keep watching till the end and also attempt the assignment question which I am going to give you at the end. And friends, do remember that you have to make your notes, proper notes, which will revise before the exams. So let's start. The first question: according to New World Wealth Report, which of the following is the world's wealthiest city? So friends, as per this report, which is the most wealthiest city in the world? It is C, New York City. Let's see why. So friends, New York City has over 65 billionaires and around 380,000 millionaires, and that's why it is the number one city in the world's wealthiest list. And the second rank, which has is of Tokyo, and San Francisco and London have tied for the third position. You can see what is the figures for the total wealth. For New York, it is 3 trillion. For Tokyo, it is 2.5 trillion. And for San Francisco and London, it is 2.4 trillion each. So this is the figures that you need to remember. Okay, let's move forward. Which of these airlines became the world's first airline to use a taxi bot on a A320 aircraft with passengers on board? Now we will see what is taxi bot in a second. So friends, the answer is Air India. B, Air India. So Air India used this taxi bot even when the passengers were on board. So let's see what it is. Taxi bot is a robot used aircraft tractor for taxiing an aircraft from parking bay to runway and vice versa. So friends, it is similar to a tractor which takes the aircraft from parking area to the runway and vice versa. So Air India became the first airline to do this with passengers on board. Okay, let's move forward. Who among the following has topped the Edelgave Hurun India Philanthropy List of 2019? So friends, I have reduced the difficulty level because I have given the photo. So the answer is B, Shiv Nadar. And you can see him in the photograph as well. Let's see some PTM. So friends, Shiv Nadar is the chairman of HCL, which is a IT company, and he has contributed 826 crores during the 2018 and 19 financial year. And similarly, Wipro's Azim Premji was on second rank because he contributed 453 crores, and Mukesh Ambani contributed around 402 crores. He was on the third position. So friends, you need to remember at least the first top three names. Okay, let's move forward. Next question: who is the first Indian musician to receive the Instagram trophy? So friends, Neha Kakkar is the first Indian musician to receive this trophy by Instagram. So up till now, only four Indian celebrities have been awarded this trophy. They are Akshay Kumar, Virat Kohli, Deepika and Priyanka Chopra. So this is a kind of trophy which is given to when you have certain amount of followers, then you get this and you have a publicly verified profile, you get this trophy. So Neha Kakkar is the first Indian musician to have this Instagram story trophy. Next question: India's longest Chinani Nashri tunnel that links Kashmir and Jammu will be rechristened after. So friends, rechristened means renamed. So after whom this tunnel is going to be renamed? After the name of Shyama Prasad Mukherjee. So let's see the PTN. Friends, Prime Minister Modi has given in 2017, he dedicated to the nation this 9.2 kilometer long tunnel, which reduced the distance between Jammu and Srinagar by 31 kilometers. And something about Shyama Prasad Mukherjee. So Dr. S.P. Mukherjee was the founder of Bharatiya Jansangh. And Bharatiya Jansangh was nothing but it's the previous form of Bharatiya Janata Party. The former Jansangh was recreated as the Bharatiya Janata Party, which you know as BJP today. Okay, very important question, so do remember it. Let's move forward. Name the India's first visually impaired women IAS officer who has taken charge as Thiruvananthapuram sub-collector recently. So friends, you can see her in the picture. She is Pranjal Patil. Let's move forward. As per the ranking of Global Hunger Index 2019, India is presently ranked at which position? So friends, you must know that India is ranked way behind, and it is ranked 102. Let's see the PTN. GHI 2019, that is Global Hunger Index 2019, puts India at 102 out of 117 countries. So friends, you can understand how dire the situation is currently. In 2018, India was 103 out of 132 countries. So we have improved a little, just one rank. We need to work very hard on it. Let's move forward. Which of the following countries continues to be on the grey list of the International Terror Financing Watchdog, FATF, that is Financial Action Task Force? So friends, you must know this question, very easy one. A, Pakistan is still in the grey list of the FATF. Let's see the PTN. Islamabad has been warned of action for its failure to combat money laundering and terror financing. So friends, FATF is still warning Pakistan that if you won't take action against terror financing, that is providing fund to terrorism, and also combating money laundering, you are going to face severe penalties and financial actions. So do remember, A is the answer, Pakistan. Next question. Name the first Indian company to reach the market capitalization of rupees 9 lakh crores recently. So friends, first company to reach this position is A, Reliance Industries. It is the first company to have market capitalization of 9 lakh crores. Another interesting fact about RIL is, RIL was also the first company to reach 8 lakh crore mark in August last year. So for 8 lakh also and 9 lakh also, Reliance Industries is the first one to reach it. Next question. Which country has approved the implementation of a web tax on large-scale web-based activity starting next year? So friends, Italy is the first country to approve this web tax. Let's see the PTN. Italy has confirmed that it will implement a 3% web tax on large-scale web-based activity from big digital companies starting the coming year. Next question. How many times has Lionel Messi won the Golden Shoe Award? So friends, I'm talking about European League. And how many times has Lionel Messi won this Golden Shoe Award? It is 6 times. And since last 3 consecutive Golden Shoe Awards has been won by Messi only. Let's see the PTN. Lionel Messi was given the 6th Golden Boot Award as he emerged as the top scoring European player for 2018 and 19 season. Let's see Cristiano's record. So he has won the award in 2008, 11, 14, 15. 4 times. Okay, let's move forward. Which of the following Indian automobile firm has recently inaugurated, has recently inaugurated India's first all-women-run automobile service workshop in Jaipur? So friends, Mahindra & Mahindra has launched this first ever completely run by women automobile service workshop in Jaipur. Let's see the PTN. So friends, company has a larger initiative which is named as Pink Collars. And what this initiative is all about is to promote the recruitment of women in core productive roles, that is related to mechanical engineering, across the company's automobile workshops. Okay, so it is under a huge initiative that they have taken. Next question. Which of these musicians have become the first Indian to receive the honor of having a minor planet named after him? Friends, you can see the person in the photo itself. He is Pandit Jasraj, and he has achieved this honor of having a small planet named after him. Let's see the PTN. The International Astronomical Union, IAU, has named the minor planet, and this is the code of the planet, which was discovered in 2006 as Pandit Jasraj. So he is holding this amazing honor. Okay, let's move forward. According to the latest National Crime Record Bureau report, which state has recorded the maximum number of murder cases among the Indian states? So friends, Uttar Pradesh is unfortunately having the highest record of maximum number of murder cases in the Indian states. So let's see the PTN. Uttar Pradesh with 4,034 cases is on the number one. and second rank is of Bihar, which is having murder cases of 2803, and Delhi is around having 487 and tops among the union territories. Let's move forward. Which of the following state for the first time in India is planning to introduce textbooks in comic form for primary classes from class 1 to 5th from the next academic sessions? So friends, a kind of innovative way of, you know, teaching the students. So which state is implementing this? Manipur is going to implement this type of books. Let's move forward. Who was selected as the 39th president of BCCI recently? So friends, Saurav Ganguly, as you might have heard, this is a very easy question. Saurav Ganguly was elected as the 39th president of BCCI. Next question. Who has been recently appointed as the new CEO of UIDAI, that is Unique Identification Authority of India? So friends, as you can see him in the picture, he is Mr. Pankaj Kumar, who has been appointed as the new CEO of UIDAI. Next question. As per the latest ranking of World Bank Ease of Doing Business report, India stands at which position? Friends, I would say this is very important question, and I think this question can be asked in exam. So please do remember the rank. It is 63rd. India has recently nicely improved on this ranking. The country was 77th among 190 countries in the previous ranking. So friends, you can see there has been a nice improvement. Okay, let's move forward. In Maharashtra and Haryana assembly election, BJP emerged as the single largest party with these numbers of seats respectively. So in the first blank you have to fill for Maharashtra and second for Haryana. Friends, actually last year SNAP asks a similar question, because last year Chhattisgarh results came for the assembly election and they asked about the number of seats of the largest party in Chhattisgarh elections. So I'm putting this question here also for Maharashtra and Haryana. So very important one in terms of SNAP. The answer is A, 105 and 40. Okay, do remember it. Government has recently accorded the Maharatna status to which of the following firms? So friends, two companies have been recently provided with this status, and they are Power Grid and Hindustan Petroleum. So my answer will be both A and B. Okay, so let's see what does this Maharatna status mean. So friends, Maharatna status is nothing but it provides much more autonomy to the management of the company. That is, Maharatna can invest from 1000 crores to 5000 crores. So they have this freedom and autonomy. Secondly, PSUs with Maharatna status can invest 15% of their net worth in a project without taking any permission from Government of India. So as I told you, basically it's all about giving more and more autonomy to the company. Okay, so my answer is both A and B. Next question. Which of these airlines has painted Ekomkar on the tail of its aircrafts in a gesture to mark Guru Nanak Dev's 550th birth anniversary? So friends, you can see in the picture, that's how the airline, you know, made a gesture to mark the Guru Nanak Dev's 550th birth anniversary. So my answer is A, Air India. Air India was the is the airline which has painted this Ekomkar on its tail. Okay, next question. Which Indian cricketer launched an animated series named Super V, which is based on his life? So friends, this is another very easy question. You must have seen about it on social media also. So the answer is B, Virat Kohli. So I have deliberately put all the V named players, but the answer is B, Virat Kohli. Next question, and very important one friends, you're going to read a lot about him for the coming years. Who among the following was appointed as 47th CJI, that is Chief Justice of India? From the photo you can see him, he is Sharad Arvind Bodpe. Okay, so he is the 47th CJI of India. So friends, now we have reached the assignment question of this session. I want you to answer these three questions, that is, the cabinet has approved a revival plan and gave in principle approval for the merger of BSNL with which other firm? So BSNL and which other firm are going to be merged together, you have to tell me. Next, which country will host the 91st Interpol General Assembly in 2022? You have to tell me the name of the country. The third and the easy question, which Indian state is to develop the country's first spiritual eco zone? So tell me the name of the state. Okay, so friends, we have reached to end to this session. I hope you guys are preparing well, because you know you need to know that the recent part, that is months of November, October, they'll be very crucial in terms of current affairs. So do give quite a lot of emphasis on the recent part also. Okay, and as I always say, please like, share and subscribe to Novation. All the best. Bye bye.